Hi guys, hope you're well. Martin from Right Page here. So this resin bound installation over in Sunbury. The weather is here, spring is here. So please, winter's out of the way and all the horrible rain. So hopefully we'll get a good run at it this year with some lovely weather. It's about 15 degrees, which is actually perfect for resin bound installation. And it's going down to about 4 degrees tonight at about 2-3 in the morning. And we are using Vuba's new moisture tolerant binder, as you can see here. So this is a moisture tolerant binder. It means that if it does start raining while you're doing a resin, it'll get you out of trouble, and obviously frost in the morning. And if there is any moisture in the air, obviously it's not ideal, but for the extra money, it's definitely worth it. So as you can see, talking about the kits, we've stacked out our oyster. It is, we've got 3 bags of 2 to 5, and we've got 1 bag of 1 to 3. That's the mix ratio. And you can see we've got our binder, our parts A, our parts B, and our quartz binder, and then each kit. So each kit goes into the mixer at one time. You put the stone in first, then you mix the resin with the whisk. That resin then goes in, and then you put the binder in, you let it mix for 3 minutes, and then it comes out. So we've got a couple of blowers here to blow the surface off to get rid of any dust and debris. I like to have a couple on board at all times in case there's any problems. We've got a power float here ready to rock and roll. So that's just been newly refurbished and serviced. We've got some new blades to go on that in a minute, so we'll get that working. You'll see that in action. As you can see here, Fraser, he's going around taping up all the edges with duct tape so that no resin or any spills get onto the edges and potentially ruin. Our wheelbarrow is covered in plastic. You see our sneaky little signboard over there, that'll be out the front showcasing our work when we've done. So as you can see, we've got yellow marking lines throughout the driveway. These marking lines, so resin is based on kits which do a certain per square meter ratio, and those kits cover a certain square meter ratio. So the reason why we mark it out in yellow is to give us an idea of how we're working, at what depth. And when you're talking about millimeters on driveways and specific depths, it's very important that you don't run out at the end of product. So I like to order a bit more so that there's a little bit left over, so it gives you a bit of room, a little bit wiggle room. And obviously this marking out system helps us know where we're going, how we're going, and at what stage. That's what the numbers are for as well. As you can see, if you come over here, all of our edges on this driveway are installed in on concrete. We've used a Marshall's Tegula 160 by 160 by 50 mil block, and that is in charcoal, going around the entire perimeter of the driveway. We've got a key curb step, which at the moment you can see is completely and utterly taped up. The reason why we completely taped up is when we tip the resin inside it, no resin spills and marks on top of the blocks. We've got the recessed manhole covers here, and we've got some strip lighting which we've installed all the way across the back of the job here. And we've got these spotlights as well down the side of the driveway. So this place is going to be lit up like Gatwick runway. This is going to be like, it's going to be literally a runway of a night time. The pictures of that will go into the video, and you'll be able to see the pictures of the finished driveway at the end of it. So obviously through this video, if you could please like, share and subscribe, that would be greatly appreciated. It helps us with the channel and it helps us to get some traction so that we can showcase our work. So while we're just getting set up, the guys are over here getting finishing off the last bits of preparation. Obviously preparation is key. Fail to prepare to fail. So I will show you when we get going, what's happening and how it's going down. Thank you. You can see here we've got a couple of spazzles level to level it out, and we've got a nice little box of tricks. We've got some new power float blades, which are there, the plastic ones. They give you a much better finish than the metal ones. And we've got some new hand trowels as well. And there are some new upgraded curved power float blades. I'm not going to try those out on this installation, but I will be trying them out in one of the next videos. Guys, so quick update in the middle of the project that we're doing now. So Adam's in here, he's just getting another mix out. Bags on top of the mixer, going in, coming out like clockwork, mixing up the resin. It's getting whisked up with a plasterer's whisk. All our empty pots are kept inside the driveway so that all the mess stays inside the driveway. Got Fraser here trailing in. I'm gonna run the power flow over the project, and you can see the sort of finish. So this power flow really presses the stone down. On our lines, we've just got mix 10, so we're on point, we're where we should be with the daisies. Crack on with the project now, and we're going to get all this resin down, and we're going to show you a lovely video at the end of it. We're going to put some after pictures in as well, so thanks for watching, guys. End of the video, the resin carpet is down and finished. Fraser is just trailing the last little bit. There's a little bit of tape left around the edges. Well, that will get taken off. So let's show you the finished product. Come on. So it looks lovely. Look at it, it's like carpet. Completely flat. It's a completely permeable driveway. Lighting installed. We'll take the tape off the front edge. So if you like what you see, please don't hesitate to get in touch via Facebook, Instagram, via the website. And I hope this video has been fun, informative, educational, and interesting. So please like, share, subscribe. If you like what you see and you want to see more, thank you very much.
You're not leaving the pots here, are you? Just a £60 deposit per person.